Dear Lord Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for bringing us today. That we can all come to the first and then that we can all say it together. And God, I ask you to protect us if we're still in school, Lord, and protect us if we're on our board, Lord, to make sure that we're all safe and that we're all passing our grades, Lord. And God, can we say amen?
Amen. Thank you. Beautiful prayer. So, let's see. I'm going to call Skylie again. Okay, do we have the song ready? Okay, we're going to play the first Noel. Skylie joined us on her tablet instead. She left me by myself. All right. While we're listening to the song, if you're not talking, you want to hear it loud and clear, you can put yourself in mute, okay? You got it? All right.
Your sound is echoing to me.
Huh?
Your sound is echoing.
Oh, the sound. So that's why I said people to like put on the, go on mute so you can hear.
Jesus,
Stop.
All right, so we got some reindeer. Okay, turkey season is out, Skylie. We got some Christmas trees. We got what else? We have reindeer. All right. Who's excited for next Saturday?
Me.
Who's been working on their project? This week is the last week to work on your project, Skylie.
I finished mine.
Okay, good. So if you're on vacation, you can start on. Good job, whoever finished. And I know people's gonna work on them. All right, so last week we talked about the birth of Jesus, right? Where was Jesus born?
We don't know.
To save us.
To save us. When or why?
Where?
Oh,
yes, he was born in Bethlehem. That's like a city. So, let's go to Isaiah chapter 7. I was going to talk to you about something else, but let's stay on the subject. Isaiah is in the Old Testament. Okay, Isaiah, let's say chapter 7. I'm going to tell you the page for the people that have the same Bible. Page 744. Okay, who have it? Can you read it for us, please? Verse 14.
What was it again?
Page 744. Emmanuel. What should we call him?
Emmanuel.
What does Emmanuel mean? Does anybody know what it means?
God with us. God with us.
Yes. So now, when we go back to Luke chapter 1 and 2, it talks about the king is born, right? So Isaiah prophesies. What does prophecy mean? Does anybody know what prophecy mean?
Foretold the future?
Yes. So it's like, in the Old Testament, we call them the prophet because God will talk to the prophet and he'll tell them to write things down. And then as they go along, whatever they write down come to pass. So now Isaiah is almost years and years and years before Jesus was born. I would say more than 500 or 600 years before Jesus was born. But Isaiah, in the prophecy, the one that we just read, verse 14, it says, therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel. Emmanuel means God with us. So in the Bible, many people that have names, many of the names that you see in the Bible, they mean something. Do you know that?
Yes.
Yes. So Deborah, do you think your name has a meaning? What does it mean? Huh? Do you know what your name means? You should ask your mom. Because your mom gave you, your parents gave you that name, right? You have a, what we call a biblical name. A name that comes from the Bible. Do you know which character are you in the Bible?
A knight.
Huh? I can't hear you. Your thing kind of stopped. Ask your mom. What does your name mean?
It's green.
Hmm? Okay, we're gonna find out what it means in a minute, okay? Okay. You ready, Deborah? I think she's frozen. Are you ready? Do you know who was Deborah in the Bible? Okay. She was a prophetess, like Isaiah, and she was a judge. Okay? You can read about your name in Judges chapter 4. Verse 4 to 14, okay? So if you have a biblical name, it means something. Some people were named after their parents. Some people named after family members. Some people just named because the parents liked the name and they named you that way, okay? Got it? So Emmanuel, let's get back to our lesson. Emmanuel means that God is with
us.
So who came? In our verse, the angel brought good, great tidings. Tidings mean news, good news. The angels brought good news for unto us, right? Yes, which is Christ the Lord. So that means Jesus is God coming to be with us. Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's why when we say Emmanuel, God is with us. So that's the name Jesus was giving. So Isaiah prophesied. And whatever he prophesied, prophecy means like he predicted, okay? So, he predicted, that's what God told him, he predicted how Jesus would be born. And that happened 700 years before Jesus was born. Can you say wow? 700 years before God, it actually happened. Some prophets call him the Prince of Peace. We call Jesus the Prince of Peace. Remember when we talk about the fruit of the Spirit? One of the fruit was what?
Peace.
And we say, who can give us peace?
God,
right? And the peace that I'm talking about, it's not silence. Because if you go somewhere, like if you go in the middle of the woods and you're sitting there and you said, oh my God, it's so peaceful. All you hear is like the birds. You don't hear cars. You don't hear the radio. You don't hear TV. We said it's peaceful. That's not the peace that I'm talking about. The peace that I'm talking about, even sometimes you feel like a little anxious. Like you're afraid about something in school, you're afraid that you might not be good, or you're scared about something, and after a while you pray, you start to feel better. That's the peace that I'm talking about. Okay? And around this season, I know that a lot of people are celebrating gifts, but that's not what we're celebrating. Who are we celebrating?
God.
God. Yes. Jesus. We're celebrating Emmanuel because he came to be with us. Right?
Yeah.
That red lipstick look really good on you, Janice. Skyly, all I see is snow. Where are you?
Everyone's screen is frozen for us.
Huh?
Everyone's screen is frozen.
Oh.
Like you're all just stuck in one pose.
Oh, everybody's frozen? Mm-hmm. Whoa. Let's try that again. Yeah, that was a nice one. Okay, let's go back. So, what's going to be our verses? What have we been talking about?
Isaiah
7, verse 14. Okay. On page 1130, we're in Luke chapter 3. Yeah. There's a place that says Logos Discovery. What does Logos mean? Anybody know what Logos mean? Nope. Logos means word. That's the Greek word for word. When we say logo, some people say like, you know, like a logo is a sign. Like, you know, your school has a logo.
Yeah.
But when we say logos, or we put S at the end, it means the word. So in your Bible, and Jemima and Sabella, I didn't forget about you. It's because of Christmas. It's taking forever for you guys to get your Bible. So, it says, there's a little story. It says, the day Jesus stayed behind. And you can read the story in Luke chapter 2, verse 41 to 52. Okay?
Can you see us?
Huh?
Can you see us?
Yes, I can see you. Can you guys see me?
Yeah.
Okay. The only person I cannot see that her video's not on is Sabella and Jemima. I can see everybody else. Okay?
I'm a reading.
Huh? All right. So, it says, I'm going to read it for you, but you can read it by yourself. Or follow along if you have the Bible. Okay. When Jesus was 12 years old, Mary and Joseph took him to the temple in Jerusalem to worship God. Back then, they used to go to the temple to pray. Okay? Not at home. And when they headed home, Jesus stayed behind to study and explore God's word. Mary and Joseph thought he was with their relatives. But when they couldn't find him, they were terribly worried. Can you imagine you go to the mall with your mom and then she was looking for you and she couldn't find you? Can you imagine that? That would have been scary for anybody, right? So, they searched everywhere they could think of. Nothing. Finally, after 3 days, they looked in the temple and found Jesus asking the teachers, probing questions and offering his own wise insight about God. Jesus pointed out that Mary and Joseph should have known he would have been in his father's house. If they would have remembered his true identity, they would have checked the temple first. Don't forget who Jesus truly is. Search for him where he can be found. Here is the moment knocking at the door of your heart. So, The reason why I say that little story, because some kids will read the story and think that Jesus was being disobedient. Why do we call him Emmanuel? What does Emmanuel mean? Right? God is with us. That's what Emmanuel means. So Jesus, they went to the temple with them, and he was only 12 years old. Okay? And he stayed behind in the temple. Because back then, in the temple, that's where people study God's word. That's where people worship. So he said, where do you think I would be? I would be at my father's house. Okay, even though Mary was worrying a lot, and Joseph was probably scared. If it was today, they would probably like call the police and put like a missing child alert. But Jesus told them, you guys should have known. I wouldn't be with relatives. I would be where? In my father's house. Because Jesus is God also. Go ahead, Skylie.
I wonder why God sent a person down at earth to have Jesus. People usually think Joseph is his father, but it's God.
Yes. That's why it says, like, So it was an angel that appeared to Mary. Okay, it was an angel. So let me read on page 1125 to answer Skylie's question about Logos discovery. That's why I get you those Bible, because you can learn as you read it. Okay. All right. So it says the king is born. In a very special way, God's spirit came upon a young woman, which is Mary, named Mary, and she miraculously became pregnant. She and Joseph, the man she was planning to marry, had traveled to Bethlehem. The only place for them to stay was in a stable. There, among the farm animals, something amazing happened. Jesus, the creator of all there is, was born as a human baby. Mary lovingly laid him in a manger. That night, angels appeared and shared the good news of the Savior's birth with the shepherds. That's our memory verse. Who were in the nearby fields watching over their flocks. The shepherd left and found Mary and Joseph and Jesus. They worshiped Jesus and spread the news that their Savior has been born. And everyone who heard about it was impressed and amazed. And then it says Christmas isn't just about gifts. That's what I said. It's about the greatest gift giver of all, God's son, Jesus. We call him Emmanuel. All right? Did that answer your question, Skylie?
Yeah.
Okay.
Isn't there a song called Emmanuel?
Yep. Who's singing? Sing it for us. Somebody was humming. All right. Okay. Can you play music for us before we go into questions? Christmas music. That's all they want, right? Yeah. A good one. Fast one. Because I like to dance. Who likes to dance? I like to dance. Skylie, you like to dance? Who have two left feet?
Huh?
Who have two left feet? If you can't dance, that's when you have two left feet. I don't know what he's doing. I'll show you. He's the one playing the songs. This is him. Not me. Look at him.
Whoa.
Whoa.
That's why you got to tell him what you guys want, or else he's going to play what he wants.
Hey, I try something, but you know.
He's recording.
All right. What song have you found for us? I have to give him a better playlist. What song is that? Yes. That one, because we had to sing it in church at Christmas Eve service. You guys heard that one, right? No, Deborah, no. You guys never heard "Oh Come Let Us Adore Him"? It's like every kid should know that Christmas song. What are they teaching you? Oh, that hurt. I thought you guys know this song. Here I am singing from the top of my lungs. Have you heard it, Janice? You never heard that song, "Oh Come Let Us Adore Him"? I even had to remember that song in Latin. They don't even speak Latin anymore.
What's Latin?
It's not spoken anymore. They used to speak it long, long time ago. It's a dead language, we call it.
A dead language?
Yeah, a dead language is a language that is not spoken anymore. So some of you, if you are like in like private Catholic school, you probably have to learn Latin, like the basic. A lot of our words come from Latin words, like science words come from Latin words.
What?
Yeah. Janice, you should drink some water. That's spicy, huh?
Of course.
She's eating taquitos. And she's not sharing. So, next for us party, I think I'm going to make cupcake. Skylar, you going to help me make cupcakes?
I've been waiting.
You guys should ask your parents to help you make cookies. Don't eat it all, though. Okay? All right. Oh, come let us adore him, Christ the Lord. All right, so that's going to be the end of our study. What is our verse for today? Jeremiah 7, verse
Isaiah.
Thank you. Somebody's paying attention. Whoa. I stand corrected. Isaiah 7, verse 4.
Verse 14.
Yes. So, you guys, if you have your list of songs that you want us to play, you can text me on Duo. Send me the songs that you want us to play so we can have everything ready to play. Okay?
Okay.
It could be Christmas songs. It could be gospel songs. Okay? All right. So we're going to ask Aisha, since she's graduating with a cap and gown on her, she's going to pray us out. Okay, Aisha? All right, let's pray.
All of us during the winter, make sure we're all safe from COVID and make sure we get good grades and we're healthy during the year. Amen.
Amen. Beautiful Amen. Prayer. Okay, everybody, stay safe. Wash your hands. If you go outside, wear your mask, okay? Because we want everybody to stay healthy. And the next Saturday, starting at 6 p.m., we're going to have a virtual party. Yes.
We're going to party.
All right. Stay safe, everyone. Have a safe vacation. Talk to you in a week. Love you. Ah. Music, please.
Bye.